President Trump has directed NASA to return American astronauts to the moon by 2024. NASA hopes one of them is the first woman to walk on the moon. And our coverage of the 50th anniversary of the moon landing continues tomorrow. That's when News Center 7's Jim Oddy walks us through Ohio's legacy in space. There are several archive videos on our WHIO streaming app right now for the moon's landing's anniversary. That includes the first steps on the moon and President Nixon's call to Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin. You can download the app on Roku, Amazon Fire, and on Apple TV. Well, I thought that this crazy heat was going to be our biggest of worries today, but all of a sudden there was just a downpour and some thunder.
Yeah, we actually had a severe thunderstorm warning at one point today that had the potential of producing damaging wind gusts. And then I saw a report coming out of Butler County near Hamilton that winds up to 50 miles an hour were reported. And take a look at this damage that was at the Butler County Fair today as those storms raced through. Might have been a scary situation for anybody that was out when those storms blew through, along with that heavy rain. Live Doppler 7 radar now, though, is looking a whole lot better than it did earlier on this evening. Clean sweeps on the radar as we're scanning the skies every 60 seconds for you. We had a few clouds that were left over from earlier precipitation, but they are slowly eroding from the west, and this is sliding off to the east. We'll have a mainly clear sky into the remainder of the night. There may be a few pockets of patchy fog by morning just because of the rain that fell earlier and the humidity that's there. Those temperatures are dropping a bit, may have some fog in the morning. Just check in with meteorologist Dante Jones, who'll let you know if we see any spots out there in the morning. Big story for the rest of the weekend ahead. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we're looking at highs in the 90s, heat index values up in the triple digits. Because of that, an excessive heat warning is in effect until 8 p.m. on Saturday. Likely Sunday, we'll see a heat advisory. We just won't reach the criteria for an excessive heat warning. The last time we had an excessive heat warning was more than a year ago, July 4th, 2018. And what you need in order for that warning to be issued is heat index values of at least 105 or higher. And that's what we're anticipating over the next 48 hours. Big dangers with this type of heat exhaustion or heat stroke potentially. So what we say to you is limit your time outdoors. If you do have to be out there, try to avoid any strenuous activities. If you start to feel nauseous, take a break, drink some water, get inside and cool off. Also tomorrow, several counties are under an air quality alert that includes Dark, Preble, Miami, Montgomery, Clark, and Greene counties, the city of Xenia, Dayton, Troy, Greenville, Eaton, and Springfield. If you have respiratory issues, tomorrow also limit being outside if possible, because it may be a little bit harder for you to breathe because of that ground level ozone getting a little bit higher. 79 degrees still right now in the city of Dayton. It feels like 82 degrees. Notice that dew point has not moved since earlier today, so that's just telling you those temperatures will not drop very far tonight. In fact, they're going to hold right around 76 degrees for our overnight low with clear skies by tomorrow morning. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll have a few scattered clouds out there, 94 degrees. We're not looking at any thunderstorm threat. I don't know why the icon is there for that. But we are going to be looking at those heat index values of 105 to 110. This is the hourly breakdown of your heat index values for tomorrow. It will feel like the mid to upper 70s in the morning, already like the 90s at 10 a.m., and then the triple digit numbers by lunchtime through sunset, and really not even much relief past that. By 10 o'clock, still dealing with heat index values in the low 90s. Along with the high heat and humidity, we have a very high UV index, not only for your Friday, but through the upcoming weekend. So drink lots of fluids and make sure that you're also putting the sunblock on if you're going to be outside. Saturday, notice that we stay sunny all day long. It is a hot one. Once again, heat index values in the triple digits. Perhaps a pop-up thunderstorm across the north for the second half of the day. Sunday will start out quiet. This is going to change our pattern. We'll first be looking at those scattered thunderstorms into Sunday afternoon and Sunday evening. And then what follows, a few residual showers or storms on Monday, but notice the big drop in temperatures. We're in the 90s this weekend, then 82 degrees on Monday. Pleasant conditions for Tuesday and Wednesday. Lots of sunshine, low humidity in the low 80s. Meteorologist Dante Jones will be up with you at 4:25 talking about that threat for that high heat for the next couple of days.
All right, thanks, McCall. This hot weather can heat up playground equipment, putting kids at risk for burns. Today, WHIO stopped by the Washington Township splash pad. With the help of the fire department, we checked the temperature of some commonly used surfaces. The concrete where people walk barefoot was 106 degrees, and those swings meant for kids were 95. We also tested out the black rubber flooring underneath the jungle gym, That came back over 120 degrees. And this heat wave is not only affecting us, it's also impacting bees. Today, WHIO spoke with a beekeeper who sells honey on Wilmington Pike in Kettering. He said the bees love the heat, but when it gets too hot, honey production goes down.
But sometimes it does get too hot for the bees, and they'll come out and they'll start gathering on the front of the hive. Be like you and I going out and sitting on the front porch to keep cool.
Mike Pittman says not having enough rain also hurts the bees because it makes it difficult to get nectar from the flowers.